is that something you have to make a decision on the left tackle this week, or can you continue to possibly rotate him?
We'll see how the week goes, and we'll decide tonight.
Do you feel like your defense is finding itself right now?
I think we're getting better.
Yeah.
I think, you know, there's still things, obviously, we have to clean up, but there's a lot of similar scheming that we're getting right now, a little bit, you know, that teams don't do going into the game, and then they come in there and give us some different types of runs. So it just takes us a little bit of a while to adjust to it. But, you know, we had, like, early in the game, you know, linebackers tried to run, they saw an opening, they tried to run through and didn't make it, you know. So there was two of those. There was, we had a misfit on the edge one time. You know, so we just got to clean those things up. The guys don't try and do too much, but we are playing better and, you know, keeping the points down, doing good on third downs.
Mike, you lost a couple of one-possession games earlier in the year. You didn't play like you wanted to yesterday, but you won a one-possession game. Is that progress?
Well, it's a win, and, you know, I think the good thing about it, Joe, is that, you know, we're not all happy about, you know, how we won. You know, I think it's easy in human nature the next week when you win a game that you're, you know, you may be not as focused or something like that. And right now, you need to be focused again from what we just did.
Did Anthony Barr play up to your level of expectation in his return?
Yeah, he did pretty good. He had, you know, I know he came over after like the third series and kind of said, you know, I feel like myself again. So that was good.
You talked about linebackers shooting gaps sometimes. How do you balance the aggressiveness of seeing a hole and shooting for it versus staying disciplined in the gap?
Well, if he can make it, he can go. You know, but they were just a little late reading it. You know, sometimes when they have two pullers and pulling from opposite sides, there's a nice seam in there. And part of the problem was if I would have been in a better coverage, we'd have got that thing secured on the front side, and I think when Len Kendricks went through, he would have made it, but I was in a bad coverage there.
When it comes to Eric Kendricks and the interceptions he's had over the last couple of years, I mean, is there something that's changed in his game, or is it just sort of an instinctual thing, right place, right time? Why does it seem like he's able to consistently make those type of plays?
Well, number one, he's very instinctive, but number two, I think he had a good idea on that play action that, you know, the route we were going to get. And the corner did a nice job squeezing him down. And then, you know, Harry was going to nail him. But he made a great interception.
What was going on with you and Kirk on the sideline?
Honestly, he's doing exactly what I wanted him to do. He's being a leader. He's being vocal. He's being showing emotion. And I've been talking to him about it all year. And, you know, it's no different when Bradford tackled me in practice, you know, because I was trying to get him to be the same thing. And so, you know, he came over and said, you like that? He kind of gave me a shove, and I shoved him back. And it's all good.
Mike, in that situation with Madison and the fumble, it kind of looked, you know, back on film like he was kind of fighting for yards there. Is there like a point of emphasis where you tell him?
It was a bad run. He missed the cut and end up going outside, and then he tried to get, you know. I think in those situations when, you know, we get the first down, we win the game. You know, so I think he made a poor judgment on trying to get the first down instead of keep the clock running.
I think Madison said last night that he wants to learn the difference between pushing it for the extra yard and rather than just kind of keeping it where the protecting the ball. You know, how do you balance that in terms of you want a guy to be aggressive and to, you know, be the guy that can go up down but can't, but also to be smart like that?
Well, I think part of that is all based on end of game situations where, you know, the stakes are a little bit higher in those situations, so guys are trying to do a little bit too much sometimes. Excuse me. So. You know, the more that he's in some of those kind of scenarios, I think that helps.
Mike, we saw the offense this year start out hot. Now the defense is playing better. Is there a way to coach complementary football to try to get those two units synced up, or is that just something that happens?
Well, I think if we ever do get synced up, we'll be pretty darn good. But, you know, it's so different because the offense isn't playing, you know, they're playing their defense and we're playing their offense. So, you know, you're going to have days like that that are not going to look as pretty on either side of the ball. And you just got to fight through it and hope that you do enough to get wins.
Mike, you've had three shots at having Kirk lead drives that were important at the end of games, and he's come through in those. Garrett Bradbury was talking about how you guys emphasize a lot those final minute drives. What are some of the, I guess, the points of emphasis that you try to deploy when it comes to those final drives?
Well, we, you know, you've got to know the situation, the timeouts, you know, what you need. We've actually started, because we've had those hiccups at the end of the first half, we're now bringing up either the offense or the defense and talking to them about just reminding them of the situation, what we're trying to do in this situation, where we're where we're going to go from there, and kind of talk them through the plays that we're going to end up running.
We had a chance a few minutes ago to talk to Garrett Bradbury. How do you feel he's come along now in his third season from a leadership standpoint?
Well, he's a good leader. I think he's more about doing his job than being a vocal guy, but he typically gets guys on the right page, and he's a first-class citizen.
Mike, Bashaud Breeland had a pretty disparaging tweet after the game. I know, obviously, frustrations boil over. Is that something that you handle disciplinary? Are there disciplinary actions coming for something like that?
We'll handle it. You know, I actually think he played pretty well. I think if I was asked a question by that reporter that he was asked the other day about being embarrassed at 103rd of PFF, I might go off on him too.
It seemed like it was more about the fan.
Yeah, I don't think it was.
You obviously know Dan Campbell a long time. He's really emotional after the loss yesterday. Do you have any experiences you can share on just, you know, going through something like that and just how you know, as a coach, you kind of get through that when your guys are, you know, fighting. Clearly, he was, you know, pretty taken.
I didn't see his press conference or anything afterwards.
He was crying. He was pretty. What's that?
What'd you say?
He was crying. He was pretty emotional.
I might have cried too. Yeah, it's an emotional game. He's an emotional guy. You know, there's been many times after we've won a game, and I come in the locker room and I'm like, man, this is crazy. You know, it's so. You know, he's a competitor, always has been, good person, and so, you know, I just feel like, you know, the best thing that happens is you get back to work the next day.
And Mike,
not that he needs advice from me.
You're heading into the bye. You got a chance to be 500 going into the bye if you win this week. Just what would that mean at this stage, just kind of to get back to even?
I think it'd be a good milestone for us to get to there. You know, there's 11 games left after that. So, you know, the season's a long process. You know, it goes, and, you know, like somebody said earlier, the offense started out good. Now the defense is playing better. You know, I think the biggest thing is we keep trying to improve every week. And, you know, if we can just continue to improve, we'll win our fair share of these games. And so, you know, it's all about improvement, keep going, staying with the process. You know, some of the players have talked to me about that. Just stick with the process. You know, keep doing what we're doing. Let's continue to get better at it.
Back to Anthony Barr, he said he was totally exhausted at times yesterday during the game. How do you feel about the way he kind of fought through that particular aspect?
Yeah, he's a tough guy and good competitor.
Time for two more.
Coach, I know you said that it was hard to evaluate Everson's, you know, individual play last night. After watching the tape, just what were your thoughts on his game?
Played really well. Yeah, he played really well. He played, it looked like the old Everson when he was rushing. He got cut on one run play. They went away from him, but you know, he's doing things like we're used to him seeing.
Do you like him in this role? Where, I mean, he's playing 72% of snaps.
He probably played too much last night, but you know, I like. we're trying to maintain him so that when we get to the end of the season, we're you know, try to keep him somewhere around 30 plays a game. I think he played 39. or something. If we can keep them at 30, 35, you know, we feel like we can maintain his athleticism and power and things like that.